Fallacies of Definition, Wikipedia Audio. Fallacies of definition are the various ways in which definitions can fail to explain terms. The phrase is used to suggest an analogy with an informal fallacy. Definitions that fail to have merit because they are overly broad, use obscure or ambiguous language, or contain circular reasoning are called fallacies of definition. Three major fallacies are overly broad, overly narrow, and mutually exclusive definitions. A fourth is incomprehensible definitions, and one of the most common is circular definitions. If one concept is defined by another, and the other is defined by the first, this is known as a circular definition, akin to circular reasoning. Neither offers enlightenment about what one wanted to know. It is a fallacy because by using a synonym in the definitions, the reader is told nothing significantly new. A straightforward example would be to define Jew as a person believing in Judaism, and Judaism as the religion of the Jewish people, which would make Judaism the religion of the people believing in Judaism. Circularity. A definition intended to describe a given set of individuals fails if its description of matching individuals is incongruous, too broad or too narrow. For example, a shape with four sides of equal length is not a good definition for square, because squares are not the only shapes that can have four sides of equal length, rhombi do as well. Likewise, defining a rectangle as a shape with four perpendicular sides of equal length is not useful because it is too narrow, as it describes only squares while excluding all other kinds of rectangles, thus being a plainly incorrect definition. If a cow were defined as an animal with horns, this would be overly broad, while if a cow were defined as a black and white quadruped, this would be both overly narrow and overly broad. Definitions can go wrong by using ambiguous, obscure, or figurative language. If beauty is defined as aesthetically successful, one must continue to break down and define the following definition. This can lead to circular definitions. Definitions should be defined in the most prosaic form of language to be understood. Failure to elucidate provides fallacious definitions. An example is Samuel Johnson's definition for oats, a grain, which in England is generally given to horses, but in Scotland supports the people. The definitions of mutually exclusive definitions list characteristics which are the opposite of those found in the definiendum. An example would occur if a cow were defined as a flying animal with no legs. In reality, a cow has legs and cannot fly, but this example claims to define a cow using a definition that is opposite to what a cow actually is. Cow and flying animal with no legs are mutually exclusive to each other, they cannot refer to the same thing. Definitions may fail by imposing conflicting requirements, making it impossible for them to apply to anything at all. An example would occur if a cow were defined as a legless quadruped. The definist fallacy is a logical fallacy, coined by William Frankina in 1939, that involves the definition of one property in terms of another. Incongruity, overly broad or narrow. Obscurity. Mutual exclusivity. Self-contradictory requirements. Definist fallacy.